I've heard a lot about this Lord Phasus fellow. Perhaps we will finally gain an audience with him at Moonglint Tower.
Very well.
I'll guide you there directly.
Our destination is rather distant. Perhaps we ought to consider employing the services of an Oxguard.
Tis the Arisen's choice to make, though I certainly wouldn't begrudge the chance to put my feet up.
I'm proud to carry out my duty. I have a favour to beg. Might you be of aid? Much obliged.
Materials, eh? I shan't deny, they have their uses. I've just had a thought. Who could have guessed that so many who were once arisen yet live? Do their strange powers stem from the time when they were arisen still? I wonder if they were possessed of steadfast wills of their own.
Know how long you'll be? I only ask so that I might adopt the most effective stance to recuperate my strength.
'Tis not our place to hurry the Arisen.
There is a chance of being beset by beasts or brigands in an ox cart, but I'm willing to take the risk to put my feet up.
Walking everywhere is certainly tiring.
This crowd's goodness.
I'm dead on my feet after the next time.
This will seem of little consequence, but different masters favour different pawns. One whom I served preferred to have beastrons for allies.
Each to their own.
I've a modest talent for spotting materials that can be used to...
Freshly rested as we are, this battle ought to be in our favor.
Remind you of a certain someone we've met.
What is the matter with you? You're under attack! Poison is a nasty affliction. Remain by your side.
Come to think of it, the pawns in this party are women all.
And yet, no two of us are the same.
I shall see to it this does not happen again.
Very well. I shall return.
Most important.
Dare I say it? We trounced our foe, well and true.
No doubt this triumph will spur us into the next. Gathering materials makes for dull work indeed.
You're soaked! Do you try not to catch cold? I shall remain by your side. I shan't allow any further attack. A ballista is a ranged weapon. This could grant us an edge in battle, if we use it well.
Who's there?
This ladder looks sturdy enough to climb.
Risen.
Another battle, with nary a moment to breathe. We must try to find a moment to gather our strength. When tarred, be sure to avoid open flames.
Methinks these climes are ill-suited to habitation. 'Tis a lonely place, to be sure.
Thank you.
You're an impatient one, Arisen.
Let us endeavor to keep up, though we are less fleet of foot. Knowing when to use curatives, I'll serve with redoubled vigor this day. Lo! A ballista! It is not how we use this, but when that counts. I imagine it would be most beneficial. Right you are.
Shall I assist?
I suppose I'll handle this.
Thank you.
spare this foe. It has a means to control pawns. We cannot afford... to fall prey to such attacks.
Ballista is a ranged weapon.
Ha-ha! I can think of all manner of uses for a contraption such as this. Might we not lay a trap for our enemies?
Cider is it? Just yonder looks to be a good spot for harvesting ingredients. Shall we see if there's all to be found?
You need not shrink from danger. We need the strength to prevail over anything. Have come through unscathed.
We mustn't allow ourselves to become complacent. Take each trial.
It would seem the stone puppet has stopped. Have the wounded been tended to?
Yes, my lord.
Good. I trust you are prepared, Sovereign of Vermund.
Will it really be all right? I'm not about to be charred, am I?
Fear not. You are in no danger. The dragon shall be under my control when it appears. Come, let us press onward.
I have a selection of wares that... Sure to please. Pleasure doing business with you.
Perusing your letters. Sir? Do you come again?
Thank you.
import stock some
wine. Peruse at your leisure, sir.
Anything's better than this.
Life's been pretty kind to me.
Getting home.
Must have taken a wrong turn.
Still waiting on that report.
I ought to report, have you?
Life's been pretty kind to come this way. Not my kind of place, this.
May I treat myself to a temple before bed?
This is a bit much for me. I best head home.
Pray, sir, have you aught to spare?
I've troubles enough of my own.
How are we to fight with such worn-out gear?
Best quality a soldier can have is in the winter.
Got to get home. I can't stay here.
I'd not leave. Did I end up
nodding off? First, assess the field.
My patience wears.
What is it? Something happened. You ought at least rest for the evening. There should be a spare bed in the lodgings yonder. Only don't go rushing off before you're ready. Take it from me. You're better off resting while you have the chance.
Everyone's as tired as I am, seems like.
I snodded off for a moment there.
Suppose I'd best be heading home.
It's just another day. Same as the one afore it.
Sooner
living's
be home.
Hard, but dreams are free, I say.
First, assess the field, then act accordingly.
Time to be heading home.
Living's odd, but dreams are free.
Sets my thoughts down dark paths, this place.
All this worrying has given me an ache.
I'd rather not draw steel if I can avoid it.
Contraption of some kind. I know not what to make of it. How shall we proceed, Arisen?
We pawns will be ready to respond, whatever the outcome.
Well now, I'm a lucky man. Thought I was waiting here for naught. But when someone finally does come along, 'tis you. I've always wanted a real fight with you, one on one. Here's my chance.
back on me, are you, Sir Arisen?
You've not heard a whisper of
reason. They call me Ragnar the Undying. It was a rotten life.
You have bested Sir Ragnar, Master. An incomparable feat, but you cannot revel in your triumph. You must press on.
I quite agree.
You got me. You got me. You got me.
My call. Your will is mine to command. Curses. This arrival of the true risen is most inopportune. Sovereign of Vermin, the ritual must not be disturbed. Let not the arisen approach. You can manage that, I trust.
It is of vital import that we have a word for you. The pretender need not be present.
Efforts suffer naught, Arisen. Now, simply watch as this world's hollow and fruitless order is remade by my hand. The ritual is complete. The dragon comes. Behold! The Royce Dragon! By my power, the dogma of dragons is unmade. You could ne'er understand, Arisen. We must must all be freed from the vulgar order wherein the dragon's existence determines all.
Hast thou summoned the resolution to face me? Then answer me this. Why dost thou fight? Is it to reclaim thy flesh, thy stolen heart? Or is it to reclaim thy throne? I offer thee a choice. Grant unto me this life in my claws, and be gone from this place. Or stand and fight. Pitiable Arisen. The time for thou to make thy choice is come. Show me the path thou wouldst walk. Go, and thou shalt live to claim thy coveted throne. Fight, and thy life is forfeit. Charges. I as the dragon, and thou as the arisen. Climb upon me. We shall depart for our true battlefield.
False benevolence.
is enshrouding this world. Arisen, pitiable soul tossed by the winds of fate. Wilt thou slay me? Or be slain? I know not how this story endeth. The outcome was determined in a time before. Upon us, we must decide a victor, and in so doing, form a link in the chain that bindeth this wheel. Tell me, Arisen, what is thy desire? Is it to slay the dragon, thereby living
focus. Here we are. The fate of Captain is upon us. A cold fear from our hearts. Our
in this battle, if we can but reach it.
When the heart is exposed, that's our chance.
Understood. Douse the flames before 'tis too late.
My will alone doth the world form a ring, an unending cycle. All is preordained, even my death at thine hands. Yet perhaps thy will is great enough to put an end to it.
Why did Sumi arisen? You have fulfilled your charge, are you not satisfied? Seek you greater status? Perhaps to rule the world entire? It is power you desire, you need merely spy out.
Choice is thine, Arisen. By thy will alone can the course of the winners of fate be altered.
You would still resist your fate. Understand you the folly of such a decision. Even the beating of your reclaimed heart was born of the great will of this world. Yet you would abandon it. Everything in this world, all that you have come to know as reality, is the creation of the great will. Should that will be lost, no mortal being could survive. However, if regret yet assails your spirit, then perhaps you should reaffirm your choice. Witness with your own eyes, or through the eyes of another, the fate of this world.
wishest to dismantle the world's will, just as I do. Yet dost thou know what awaiteth the world, should it meet such a fate? Would become a fleeting, fragile, vacuous thing, bereft of the cycle. Naught would be born into it save chaos, great and terrible. Surviving in such a world would be no simple matter. Yet, if thy will is set upon the truth, thou must demonstrate its strength. Prove through thine actions that thou canst cast off this wheel. Think well, Elizabeth, but rest not. I will know thine answer through the strength of thy will. Thou shalt cut a swathe through the false benevolence enshrouding this world. Arisen. Soul tossed by the winds of fate. Wilt thou slay me, or be slain? I know not how this story endeth. The outcome was determined in a time before Reckoning. And yet, arisen, born of a hapless faith, there is maybe. Chance, 'tis thy will and thine alone that couldst contest the great will of this world. Thou art too late. The hour is upon us. We must decide a victor, and in so doing, form a link in the chain that bindeth this wheel. Tell me, Arisen, what is thy desire? Is it to slay the dragon, thereby living in darkness? Dost thou merely seek conflict with the mighty foe? Thank you.
focus.
Thank you.
greatly aid us in this battle if we can reach it.
Now thou wilt witness my true strength.
Bathe this fiery breath. Strike if it recovers. Strike the...
Tired of this folly. Canst thou do no better?
I shall draw its focus.
Why do you pursue me, Arisa? You have fulfilled your charge. Are you not satisfied? Seek you greater status? Perhaps to rule the world in time. It is power you desire, you need merely spy out the path.
The choice is thine, Arisen. By thy will alone can the course of the winners of fate be altered.
Still resist your fate. Understand you the folly of such a decision. Even the beating of your reclaimed heart was born of the great will of this world. Yet you would abandon it. Everything in this world, all that you have come to know as reality, is the creation of the Great Will. Should that will be lost, no mortal being can survive. However, if regret yet assails your spirit, then perhaps you should reaffirm your choice. Witness with your own eyes, or through the eyes of another, the fate of this world.
It is thy will to defend the world, then thou needst simply bring me low. Yet what reason hast thou to attempt such a feat?
Turn back.
Leave now, while you can.
You have strayed, Arisen. And for what? Lest you forget. You have a world where you belong. There, you are to fell the great evil in your path and rule the people as their sovereign. For that is who you are. And it is my wish that you should live out that life of purpose. The time has come for you to return. Go. My children shall see you there safely.
Let us go home. Together.
To a world under your rightful rule.
To a world all your own.
this is your will, then behold, a world unmerciful, bereft of the benevolent hands of darkness. This is your world, the world to which you longed to return. Alas, if only you had chosen to become sovereign. At the end of your travails, you could have ruled over these lands in perpetual peace. Yet that world of limitless possibilities has ended. You stand now upon its remains, the vestiges of a world that could have been so much more. Innumerable wills have served to deliver this world from extinction time and time again. You alone have refused to carry out that great purpose. What you see before you is the consequence of your apathy. Behold. As it has failed to be chosen, and as 'twill ne'er be read, this world will soon cease to exist. In the blink of an eye, the sickle of oblivion will reap aught that you have known. I would advise you not to waste these last moments. Explore the remnants of this world while you can. Perhaps, in doing so, you shall come to see the truth. And know the wretchedness of a world unworthy of being chronicled. How shall you fare, I wonder? Will you endure in this world, abandoned and unprotected?